बिहारचे माजी राज्यपाल डॉक्टर डी वाई पाटिल जी, डी वाई पाटिल विद्यापीठांचे कुलपति डॉक्टर पी डी पाटिल जी, महाराष्ट्र सरकार का पारक मंत्री पुणे श्री गिरीश बापट जी, मानद कारण आचार्य अच्युत सामंत जी, मानद कारण विष्णु पर्णेकर जी, मानद कारण डॉक्टर प्रताप सिंह यादव जी, डी वाई पाटिल विद्यापीठ यांचे कुलगुरु डॉक्टर पी एन राजदान जी, डी वाई पाटिल विद्यापीठ यांचे रजिस्ट्रार डॉक्टर ए एन सूर्याकर जी, सर्वांना नमस्कार। पुणे येथील नवव्या पदवीदान समारंभासाठी मी आते खूप आनंद आहे। तोट्या वेळाचा अपर्या विद्यापाठने केलेल्या प्रशंसनीय प्रवासीची नोंद घेण्यास मला आनंद वाटतो। आज अपना सर्व पदवीधर होण्याची माझी शुभेच्छा आणि भविष्यात तुम्हाला एक फायद्याचे करिअर हवे आहे। माय डियर यंग फ्रेंड्स, आई कांट स्पीक टू यू इन युअर ब्यूटिफुल ग्रेट लैंग्वेज मराठी, आई हैव टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश और हिंदी। टुडे आई एम डिलाइटेड हियर टू बी हियर फॉर द 9th कॉन्वोकेशन ऑफ डॉक्टर डी वाई पाटिल विद्यापीठ पुणे, विच वॉज ग्रांटेड द डीम्ड यूनिवर्सिटी स्टेटस बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी in 2003. I am also happy to note that the commendable journey made by our Vidyapeeth in a short span of time. Convocation is an important and memorable milestone in the lives of the students who are passing out today. At the same time, it also reaffirms the invaluable role played by the institution and its teachers in imparting knowledge and shaping the outlook and personality of every student. Convocation also symbolizes the importance of continuity and the duty of each generation in transmitting knowledge, wisdom, and cultural values to the next generation. I am told Vidyapeeth offers graduate, postgraduate, super speciality, also doctoral programs in various disciplines of healthcare. As many as 1,056 students are getting their degrees in this convocation. I am glad to know that 19 students are getting gold medals and 12 others are being awarded PhD degrees. I extend my heartiest congratulations to outgoing students for their achievements and my sincere appreciation to parents for nurturing the talents of their children. I am particularly happy that majority of the students are the recipients of these awards are girls. That's a very, very positive thing for the country. Women empowerment is the need of the hour. They constitute 50% of the population, so we have to take care of their education. I am happy that the Vidyapeeth is promoting education in that direction, and then the girls are taking advantage of the same and excelling their life. Recognizing the contribution made by eminent personalities in various fields is part of Indian culture. I am happy that Vidyapeeth is honoring 3 such personalities by conferring on them degree of Doctor of Letters honoris causa and Doctor of Science honoris causa. The contribution of these great personalities needs a special mention and appreciation. I personally know Dr. Achyut Samanta, who has been given the Doctor of Science conferred on him for his contribution to the field of education and social transformation of tribal children in the country. He is having education institutions in Bhuvaneswar in Orissa and is educating freely 25,000 children, tribal children. That's a great service. And I also congratulate Dr. Pratap Singh Yadav for the Director of Letters conferred on him for his contribution as a social reformer and progressive agriculturist. Just now, as he said, it's not only question of a newspaper, it's a social movement to educate the people, to enlighten the people, to guide them in proper way to become responsible citizens. I also congratulate Vishnu R. Parneka for the Doctor of Letters conferred on him for his contribution in establishing social economical and spiritual organizations and spreading the life management philosophy called Purnavad. India is internationally known for its spirituality. Spirituality is the need of the hour. And in the modern world, when we are all moving towards materialistic life, the spirituality gives us solace, gives us balance, gives us confidence, gives us all the stamina to face the challenges. That's why he has been chosen for this response, this job. I'm glad to know that Vidyapeeth, with its motto to uplift the society, is focusing on importing education various disciplines such as allopathy, homeopathy, and Ayurveda, besides dentistry, nursing, physiotherapy, optometry, visual sciences, biotechnology, bioinformatics, and management. Today, in the modern world, two things are important. IT is important. At the same time, BT also is important. If IT and BT combine together, you can get beauty and you can make the country mighty also. That has to be understood by one and all. I am happy that these courses are given encouragement by the Vidyapeeth. Dear sisters and brothers, higher education has a unique role in preparing the torchbearers of tomorrow in different fields, from medicine to management. Irrespective of whether the students choose to become teachers, administrators, businessmen, or social scientists, it is essential for higher education institutions to mold the next generation by inculcating values of patriotism, honesty, responsibility, discipline, compassion, respect for women, and pluralism. I am sure the teachings and research projects taken up by Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth are fully tuned up to the requirements of the 21st century knowledge society. Today, the digital revolution is sweeping the world and technology is completely changing facet of our life. We not only have to keep the pace with the various advancements, but we also need to visualize future requirements and reorient our curricula accordingly. Dear students, please remember that there is nothing like a full stop in learning. Learning is a lifelong process. It is a continuous process, and a graduation is just a chapter in the book of your life's journey. Keep adding more chapters as you continue in this journey of knowledge, self-discovery, and self-realization. Do not content with what you have achieved in terms of knowledge and skills or securing employment. Education does not end with earning a degree. It is a sum total of knowledge, skills, attitude, and behavior, and aims at holistic development of a person. Education is not only for employment. Education is for enlightenment. Education is for enhancement of your knowledge. Education is for empowerment of yourself. And then education is for employment also. Keeping this in mind, you must continue to learn before you start again. The world of learning and acquiring knowledge has no boundaries. An essential future of medical profession is to keep updated constantly through training programs. I understand that many students, after graduating from Vidyapeeth, might prefer to pursue further studies in Institute of Higher Education, either in India or abroad. I have no problem. I don't think there is any need to go abroad nowadays. Everything is available here. But still, if you want to go, I have a simple advice. Go, learn, yearn, and return. At the end of the day, you must come back, work for the society and for the country, enjoy the fruits of development and your stature and your personality and your understanding with the rest of the society and with the family members. That gives you real, real happiness. If you go abroad, earn money, purchase a bungalow, and also purchase a car and send a photograph to your mother and grandmother, they will not be happy. Outwardly, they may appear to be happy. It's like wearing a suit, boot, hat in a bathroom and standing in front of a mirror and then feeling satisfied that I am wearing a suit. It's like that if you go abroad and purchase something and become something and then send photographs to your family members. You must come back and then work for the society, and then make the family happy and make the surroundings also happy. So that's why I say, go, learn, yearn, and return must be the credo. Never neglect or forget your mother tongue, place of birth, and the motherland. Har ek vyakti, apna maa, apna janma bhumi, apna matru bhasha, apna matru desh ko kabhi bolna nahi chahiye. Ma, the mother has given you this beautiful life. You must always remember her, respect her, take care of her. Mother means father also. Secondly, janma bhumi, the place where you are born, jahan aapne paida hua, wahan, us ilake ke bare mein aap kahan tak bhi pahunche to bhi, phir bhi apna janma bhumi ko yaad rakhna chahiye. Tisra, matru bhasha, jo maa ka garbh se jo aaya matru bhasha, marathi ho, telugu ho, tamil ho, kannada ho, असामी हो, पंजाबी हो, भोजपुरी भी हो, वो भाषा को कभी भूलना नहीं चाहिए. घर में आपस में मातृभाषा में ही बात करना चाहिए, ये बहुत जरूरी है. ये कमजोरी है हमको कॉलोनियल रूल के कारण से. ब्रिटिशर जाते जाते केवल उनका एजुकेशन सिस्टम हमारे ऊपर थोपा नहीं, हमारा माइंड भी उन्होंने थोड़ा रीसेट करके गया. इसलिए जितना जल्दी हम कॉलोनियल माइंडसेट से बाहर आ पाएंगे उतना अच्छा होगा देश के लिए. देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन लर्निंग इंग्लिश बट वी शुड नेवर बिकम इंग्लिश मैन. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस. आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम बट एट द सेम टाइम यू मस्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्पीक इन योर मदर टंग, टॉक टू योर मदर एंड फादर. द वीकनेस इज नॉट ओनली इन द स्टूडेंट्स, द वीकनेस इज ऑल्सो इन द पेरेंट्स. I want to impress upon the parents also, because the parents, even if they are not educated, their children, babu, mummy, daddy kaho. Mummy kyon kahna, daddy kyon kahna, ye mummy, daddy, bidi, jadi, culture kya hai, humko samajh mein nahi aa raha. Ye maa kaho, antaral se aata hai. Mummy kaho, muh se aata hai. Try to experience it tonight. Go home and then try to say maa, it comes from here. Try to say mummy, it comes from here. That is the difference between a mother tongue and other language. Nothing wrong. Again, once again, I stress learning other languages. But before you learn other languages, you must learn your language, because you will be able to articulate better in your mother tongue. You will have original thoughts. You will have original expression. You will have more comfortability, and you will have more original thinking in your mother tongue. So be comfortable. I felt happy when the Sanskrit slokas were read as part of the education, because Sanskrit is one of our great ancient language from which we derive our culture, our heritage. Friends, never succumb to pressures or temptations that will make you tread on the wrong path. Strong character, discipline, hard work, unwavering commitment and passion to the goals set by you must always be your guiding principle. I always say character, caliber, capacity and conduct, they are important, along with discipline, dynamism, dedication, devotion. But unfortunately, in our society, because of political leaders and other people who consider everything as vote bank, some of them have started using not the other four C's, character, caliber, capacity and conduct. Instead of that, they are using the other four C's: caste, community, cash, and criminality. We should never fall prey to this, the other second part of the four C's. The first part is important: have the character, caliber, capacity, and conduct, and then you will become an ideal citizen. What is meant by patriotism? We are in the place of Balagangadhar Tilak. We are in the place of Dr. Swatantra Veera Savarkar. I am there in Maharashtra, which was in the forefront of the freedom movement. What is patriotism? Patriotism means loving the country. Country do not mean boundaries. Country means all people, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region. India is one, one nation, one people, one country. We should all remember that. We may belong to different regions. We may have different religions. We may speak different languages. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, फिर भी अपना एक देश विविधता में एकता भारत का विशेषता ये हमेशा हम लोग याद रखना चाहिए. दिस इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी इन द पेरिकुलर टेंडेंसीज एंड डिविजिव फोर्सेस आर रेजिंग देयर अग्री हेड एंड पॉलिटिशियंस आर अदर वेस्टेड इंटरेस्ट पीपल दे ट्राई टू प्रमोट कैस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ वोट्स. इट इज टाइम दैट द यंगर जनरेशन एंड द स्टूडेंट फ्रेटर्निटी एंड एकेडमिक कम्युनिटी वी मस्ट कम फॉरवर्ड एंड देन move in the direction of thinking that we are a great nation, we have a cultural identity, unity in diversity, plurality is in our life. The so-called secularism is not there because of constitution, not because of mercy of any politician. Secularism is safe in India because secularism is part of our DNA of every Indian. Every Indian DNA is secular. Sarva dharma samabhavana, sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. That is the philosophy of this great land. We are an ancient nation. We are a great civilization. Babylonian civilization, Roman civilization, Egypt civilization, Greek civilization. What happened to those civilizations? And see, Indian civilization, in spite of foreign rule, in spite of colonial rule, where people came and attacked us, ruled us, ruined us, and looted us, and cheated us also. In spite of that, why this civilization is surviving? Because we believe in sarve jana sukhino bhavantu, we believe in vasudhaika kutumbam. Entire universe is one country. That is the approach of Indians. That atithi deva bhava, guru deva bhava, matru deva bhava, pitru deva bhava, that is the Indian thought process. We must remember that and we must follow the same. India, my young friends, before the colonial rule, even after that also, 27% of the world GDP used to come from India. 27%. Now we are struggling hard to have 7%, 8%. But India has never attacked any country in the history. That's why Indian civilization is surviving. All time Dick and Harry came and attacked us. They made us colonies. But we never. India was known as a Vishwa Guru once upon a time, Nalanda University. And you have so many great scholars in those ancient days. So, keeping that tradition, we must now again work together, learn together, live together, and then think of sharing the prosperity with others. You have to think in terms of others. That is the Indian culture. That is Bharatiya Sanskriti. ये हमारा जीवन पद्धति है. आदि काल से, वेद काल से, पुण्य काल से, पुराण काल से पूर्वजों ने जिया और दिया, विरासत में उनको मिला, वही भारतीय संस्कृति है. उस संस्कृति को कायम रखना चाहिए. हमारा जीवन में भारतीय संस्कृति को हम लोग कायम रखना चाहिए. माई यंग फ्रेंड्स, दैट इज अ वे फॉरवर्ड. दैट इज अ वे वी हैव टू थिंक इन टर्म्स ऑफ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. इनोवेशन इज द की टू सक्सेस इन टूडेज वर्ल्ड. डोंट हैव योर प्रेडिसेसर्स or peers blindly. Think creatively to find solutions to the problems faced by the society. It is also important for you to dream, to make a mark and achieve success. Dream high, aim high, but work hard to reach that dream. Albert Einstein had once said, I am enough of an artist to draw freely on my imagination, which I think is more important than knowledge. Knowledge is limited, imagination encircles the entire world. This is what Einstein has said. Dear sisters and brothers, and my dear youngsters, this institution is called a Vidyapeeth. Vidyapeeth. This word that is commonly used by many to refer university has a lot of meaningful, suggestive connotation that goes to the root of Indian conception of education. We should try to understand how an ancient Indian thinkers have encapsulated a lot of concepts in simple terminology. Vidya denotes to discover and know what it is. Peet means a center or a pedestal. So a Vidyapeeth is center where the discovery of new facts and unraveling of new knowledge goes on, because it is a peet. It is a sustainable foundation for further learning. In the Indian worldview, we are all lifelong partners, learners. Learning is a lifelong process. Please note that Vidya emphasizes the spirit of discovery and innovation. so crucial for our present and future growth as a learning society. Many successful individuals in the world have followed this approach and became famous. This is not an easy path. There will be obstacles. There will be failures. What matters is your ability to stay focused, trying to discover new realities and to pursue your dreams undeterred by failures and obstacles. I would like to highlight the critical importance of language learning in our education system. Language is a tool of transformation of culture. It's a reflection of our ideas and values, our thoughts and emotions. It is truly the lifeblood of a civilization. Language is the lifeblood of a civilization. We live in a globalized, multilingual world where language is not only a means of communication, but is also a window to the treasure house of literature, music, and fine arts. It is the invisible thread of our cultural fabric, of all these languages. Our mother tongue, the language of home, is the root of the huge tree of life. The mother tongue is the root of the huge tree of life. We must ensure that this foundation is strengthened. We must all learn our mother tongue well. We must constantly nourish it by speaking, writing and producing literature in the language and use it in schools, colleges and universities. We in India have a rich heritage of literature in so many Indian languages. We must preserve this and enrich it further. We must remember that language is a living tool. Remember that language is a living tool. You must use it or you lose it. If you don't use it, you lose it. Try to understand. If we lose a language, we lose an important part of cultural identity of our nation. Mahatma Gandhiji said once, I quote, "We, the English educated Indians, often unconsciously make an assumption that the microscopic minority by English speaking Indians are the whole of India. That's not correct. For him, governing the people and running day-to-day administration has to be in Indian languages, the language spoken and understood by the people. In fact, democracy and Surajya can be strengthened only if institutions of governance like courts, offices, use local language. That day should come and we must work in that direction. I would like to underscore that all the states should consider using local language extensively in the day-to-day work. It could also make it an integral part of the school curriculum, an essential qualification for employment and at appropriate levels in the administration. I am keen that each Indian should be proficient in his own mother tongue. At the same time, we should learn as many languages as we can and need. We should broaden our horizons, strengthen our bonds with our heritage through classical languages like Sanskrit, and also acquire knowledge in our other world languages. But our feet must firmly be on the ground. Our proficiency must be strong in our native mother tongue. Mother tongue is veritably our eyes. Rest of the language are useful add-ons like eyeglasses. Your mother tongue, your eyes are like your mother tongue. And then this chashma is like other language. If you have eyesight, then you will have sight. You don't have eyesight, even if you wear Ray-Ban glasses, nothing is going to be visible. Understand this. This is very important for all the youngsters. So we should focus on learning our mother tongue. Friends, finally, I call upon you to imbibe the core values of our culture, traditions, heritage, and history. We must have the traditions of respecting and living with nature. Respect nature, promote culture for a better future. Respect nature, promote culture for a better future, your own future. Be proud of your parents, teachers, and institutions. The Google is very important, very useful. But please understand and remember, Google can never replace Guru. Guru is always important. They are the people who shape our personalities and careers. Always remember that whatever you do, wherever you are, you should always be an Indian and an alumni of the Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. Friends, what I want to tell you all is today on this occasion, you must be feeling proud of your parents who have assembled here. You must be feeling proud of your children. They have acquired the wings to fly, and sky is the limit for them. May my best wishes for all of you for a wonderful and rewarding career. What I want to say at the end is everybody should know the history, the past, the heritage. Everybody should remember and feel proud of their culture. And everybody must respect Mother Janma Bhumi, Mother Tongue, and also Mother Land. We must also try to live with the nature along with your culture for a better future. My compliments to all the people who have been given this doctorate. Why this felicitation? Felicitation is to give inspiration to others. If you also work hard, you will also get some award like this. This is a recognition. Ye Bharatiya Parampara hai, jinke paas panditya hai, kala hai, jinke paas knowledge hai, unko pehchanna, unko puraskar karna, ye Bharatiya Parampara hai. This is the speciality of Indian culture. That's why today we are felicitating these people, these personalities, for their outstanding performance in their respective fields. So every one of us, we must aim to become something special in life. Simply becoming a graduate or a doctor or an actor will not suffice unless you specialize, unless you contribute something to the society, unless you live for others also, then life has no meaning. Please understand this message and try to move forward. India is on the move. The entire world is once again looking towards India. Investments are coming. FDI is open now. World Bank says, World Economic Forum says, ADB says, even Moody's ratings, not Modi ratings, Moody ratings also say India is on the rise. Future is ours. 21st century must belong to India. If we all work together, and if we all think this is our responsibility, common responsibility, to take the country forward and have the agenda of development, development, development. Don't get involved into parochial, don't get involved into divisive tendencies, don't get getting involved to fall prey into the social evils. What is upper caste and what is lower caste? Who created this? Where is the sanction for the, in the Shastras for the same? It is really a shame, even after so many years, we still have to deal with some situation where the people are not allowed. And you have a situation where the women are not treated properly and equally. In India, we have a tradition that we always respect women as mother. India, we call it as motherland, Bharata Mata, Bharata Pita Nai. And also take the names of the rivers, Narmada, Tapati, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Yamuna, Saraswati, Mahendra, Tanaya, all rivers are named after women. Even in the Puranas also, it is not only gods, goddesses were there. Saraswati Devi was in charge of education. Parvati Devi was education of defense. Even now, the lady is, the woman is a defense minister. Then Lakshmi Devi was the finance minister, according to my theory. That's the respect we used to give to women. So now, this Nirbhaya card, or some incidents happened here and all, they are really a challenge to all of us. The enlightened youngsters, the progressive-minded people, they must come forward and change the mindset of the people who are ignorant or innocent or who are doing it for something or other. We should not fall prey to that at all. We should not get ourselves involved into these sectarian tendencies. That is my advice to the younger generation. If you work hard, as I told you, this is a fertile land. I am here in Pune, the historic city, the Pune, the Maharashtra. The lands are very fertile and the brains are also very fertile. If you use them properly, then we can build up a great Maharashtra. And by creating a great Maharashtra, you can create a great Bharat, that is India. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.